Welcome back to more Crew San Andreas. It's sort of cut off a bit probably last episode, but I literally realised just in time that we've been for 3 minutes. So I was saying this mission's really one I despise, maybe for obvious reasons. It was just annoying, like keeping this plane this low. You're always tempted to just go a bit high. And you're really fearful of going that bit lower, because right now it's sort of changing the camera angle so better. And you can see how low I'm, like, lower than that hill is. But yeah, looks like Torino's missions are hit and miss, so what am I really doing? Vertical bird we're going to do later on, much later on again. It's a really tough one, but that's a really fun one. Because you actually end up with what's it called? A hydra? Yeah, hydra's like... I suppose officially it's said to be the most badass plane slash heli in the game, but I do think that heli, the hunter's better, because I think it's a bit easier to fly. The hydra's a bit hard to handle, and it was that hydra race that is the one that's really daunting to me, really off-putting. So yeah, that's like a race we'll do later on. So race, it's just you doing it in a checkpoint, and you can do it in any time, but it's just impossible. So hydra's so hard to handle. Did I even get that? Alright, I did. Yeah, sometimes it can be easy to think you've got the corona and you actually haven't, so just double check it. Now, nearly made it back with one wing last time, so hopefully this time it goes hot into it. So I think there's a couple more for Torino after this. Certainly a mission called Stowaway is going to be coming up, which is quite fun. Then yeah, pretty soon the troops missions will start. There's a couple. And it's the first one that you get the jetpack in, I think, so that's the time when I'm going to be like making it a bit of a the rounds around the whole city, sort of picking up anything that can be bought and what have it. Now don't worry about the mass of them ships, I think you can sort of just fly through it, and might as well try the cutting side approach again, because if I take it from this side, I mean it's a lot easier to avoid visibility. Should also be subsequently easier to land then as well. Unless you're flying above radar then and above parts of that, but you have to stay high because the canyons are coming. It's a bit too harsh sometimes, isn't it? You should bear in mind what's in front of you rather than what's immediately below. Right, we're fine now. Finally get this mission out. Done.
Nice going, Paul. Really, you did good.
My guess is this one's start. Now this one's actually really failable right from the start, because you've got to get on this plane in a motorbike and you've got to be sort of pretty quick about it. But of course the good thing is if you do fail, all you have to do is turn around, head to the end of the runway and just start straight again.
What's your take on this?
Damn! I thought them was your people.
Listen, Carl, we've got a problem. Some traitors from another department think they can help the overseas situation by financing militaristic dictators in exchange for arms contracts.
Hey, ain't that exactly what you do?
Well, kind of, but we get to pick our dictators. Degenerates that we can control. We try to stay the hell away from these guys with principles, because that just muddies the waters.
Yeah, okay.
Okay, so, of course, these idiots have stolen a consignment of landmines, and they plan to offload them in the Middle East and cause a little ruckus, and everybody goes crazy and have a lot of problems. I mean, Carl, do you like maiming people? Curious.
Maiming? Some people? Shit.
Anyway, the point is, you and me, Carl, hey, we're the same. Now, yeah, it's a dirty job, but somebody's got to do it. But if you screw this up, it causes a tinderbox situation all over Latin America and the Middle East. Now, look, I spoke to the big man. You got clearance to eliminate these fuckers. How's that? Huh?
Man, kill government agents.
Kill Schmidl. Come on, don't look at it that way. Well, yeah, think of it as pest control. It works for me. All right, come on. I can't stay here now. I'm too hip. I gotta go. Okay? I'm out of here.
Yeah, so pretty heavy stuff. I'll put one of the big man, the head of the CIA, wherever he's from, or the president. Who knows? This Carl's doing some really like dodgy shit right now for Torino. So just head right up here, then right. Wow, I did that amazing trick. What you do is sort of stay behind the runway once you get past the barrels, and the bike will notice we're gaining speed as it's like in a wake of the plane. But yeah, it can be easy to get caught up with the barrel stuff falling out. That's probably the quickest I've ever gotten a plane. So I'm happy with that. And as I said, avoid using what's the name? Guns on this. I think this guy's having me off right now. Use my counter. That'll do. Let's take his head off. So just keep driving your way through here, killing these mugs. And there's another few up here.
This ain't gonna be free.
Sorry.
Well, you know nothing.
Look at this guy again. Smith or something.
Carbon base.
They only give him one, so I'm sure they fuck this up. Oh, don't know. And you sort of fall out by the train tracks. So we've got a hell of a long way to jump on. It shows how high up we've gone. But I always quite like this bit. It is just badass. Carl just like sneaked on a plane, blew it up and parachuted up. So I'm just going to head straight there again. I think despite the symbol, that is if the Torino's mission's for now. I can't think of any others stopping it. So this one might just be Black Project, which is the jetpack up. So as you can see, if you look at the left-hand bar, it gives you altitude. There's always temptation the first time to do it as it's dropping, but it actually has two drops on this little bar. So really, it's that good that you only really have to consider pulling it about now. Yeah. And just this tiny little bit is enough to slow us down from that ridiculous fall.
Catalina.
Yes, Catalina.
Hey, I know it's you. What's eating you, baby?
I don't love you no more.
Well, hey, that's just... Hello?
There, hey Catalonian TT3, I couldn't mind her in this game so much, but she's still crazy. And yeah, she will ring up four times, I think, so that's phone call two. Now this sort of restricted area next to us is going to feature in the next mission for this one, I'm thinking of. We have to sort of infiltrate that to find out why it's so restricted. Because they're working on the jetpack, which is about like $60 million project. And two fast cars a robot. I'm pretty sure he doesn't give them actually anything in return, but yeah, you do get access to it in the what's the name? The runway. So it's the only place it spawns. It's a bit unfortunate, but it's worth it, definitely. Got the weapons I need for this back project. Sniper's important. A silencer would be good as well, but yes, come on. I really do like this mission, so I'm happy it is this one.
Torino, where are you?
Wrong devil, CJ.
Truth! How are you?
In better shape than you, fat ass.
What? Hey, you watching me?
Can't talk now. I need your help for something.
Wonder
special.
If that changes Come the dialogue based on Carl's weight in the game, actually.
I'll be waiting.
Hey, man, what the? Dang!
You are kidding me.
I ain't that chubby.
I seriously don't think it's gonna ask me to lose weight. Well, right, so it shows that I'm never usually fat in the game because I've never ever had that before. And that is ridiculous, isn't it? Running too fast for the jetpack, right? So that is irritating because the nearest gym's quite a way away as well. So I suppose I have to go to this gym anyway and learn the moves. Pretty challenging, so I might as well do that. Just spend my time solely on the bike. Then I can do that mission. I'm still quite surprised that happened. I never thought the weight would actually affect the mission on the game, otherwise I would not have carried on eating after. And Barbie. Oh my god, flew then. That's all back to go. Remember this, by the way? I think I've got plenty of these, but yeah, you have a pump shotgun underneath this bridge, no doubt. Never knew that myself, to be honest, until that point, too. Just always handy to know, so yeah. So I imagine all I have to do is sort of get it below half.